There are so many forms of exclusion, and I don't believe that exclusion is an event that when you implement or something like that, boom, the conflict will happen or something like that. Most of the time, it's a process which builds up over time, and people have grievances that they don't manage to express. And West Africa is a region. Each country is different, 15 countries, and the contexts are different, despite the fact that we have a lot of communality. And the exclusion is not even one form of exclusion. There's so many forms of exclusion, the political exclusion that you see, which affect massively women and different ethnic groups. And women, of course, did not resort to violence in any way. And you look at the north of Mali, it's not only political exclusion, it was economic exclusion, social exclusion, even cultural exclusion somehow. So depending on the country and the nature of the exclusion, you know, there are different conflicts. So you have to do a deep analysis of each conflict to be able to determine which kind of exclusion have contributed to violent conflict. Wow, that is a big one. Because myself, I think about this a lot, and as I keep saying everywhere, no matter what type of intervention we do, how much money we fuel into development projects and different activities, women constitute more than half of our population. Qualitatively and quantitatively, we cannot exclude them. But how to integrate them? What I have noticed through some work I have done with UN Women last year in May is that women don't have the technical and the financial resources. You have many women candidates who are very courageous and want to transcend the political scene and so on, but they don't have the support. So organizations come, they see one training here and there, but to be like a candidate, whether it's local elections or national election and so on, you require a lot of resources, and campaigning costs money and so on, and women don't have the support. So we need to provide them with the support in order to be able to transcend, because the laws are there. If you look at the Maputo protocols, which say that women have to be integrated at all level, and then you look at Resolution 1325, and all of our national laws, you know, talk about our constitution, talk about against discrimination and exclusion and so on. But yet, women are not able to climb. So I really think that we have to have targeted support, technical support and financial support. Also, we need to put the quota system, which is working in some of the countries. If you look at Senegal, it's working there properly, and then you look at Cape Verde. But yet, we have a long way to get. Most of the time, I think it's very simple, and we need to have a change of attitude and work on our own assumptions and our own biases, and that when you come in this any system, don't act like you know the context more than the people who live there. And the bottom line is, you know, when I come in your house, you know your house more than I do. And international actors have to play a supportive role, not to lead the process for the local people. People learn by doing, not by, telling them go left and right and things like that. And then also, you can set the agenda for people and expect that, you know, that process can be sustained and so on. And the other aspect is also the issue of flexibility. Most of the time, international actors come and whatever they're bringing is like really time-bound, you know, and they're not flexible. And when you come in the context of conflict, this is a long process. So you have to have time, resources, and patience to ensure that, you know. And also, international actors, they need to understand one thing. Anybody who survives years of conflict have so much resilience. So the assumption to always say, oh, they don't have the capacity. The starting point is the resilience. You need to build on the resilience and not, you know, come in and assume that, you know what, there's no capacity here. So the only way we can sustain and have this collaboration and really talk, walk the talk, because we get at a rhetoric level, very intellectual, sustaining peace, Agenda 2030, but if we want to be really make sense, because one problem that affects my country will affect the neighboring country and eventually everybody. So we are in a global world and we need to work in global solidarity and again, let the people who are affected by the problem lead the process.